it's Linda Voorhees, and you can visit my website at voorscript.com. And every conversation and every bit of discussion is about screenwriting. And I hope that's why you found me, and I hope that's part of what can go on here is to extend our community of screenwriters. And I wanted to use the opportunity for these video clips to talk a little bit about screenwriting, to see if I can tap into some of the things that you need, and to see if I can help you a little bit with things that get a bit bumpy. And part of what I do want to talk about is the emotional life of a writer, because quite frankly, I'm going to say the mechanics of screenwriting, the toolkit of screenwriting, probably for my podcast, because I just need a little more time to go into detail, the detail of those mechanics and those tools. And it eats up quite a lot of time, and I would rather do that with an audio tool rather than the video. So what I do want to talk about is essentially the writer's best friend. And surprise, surprise, the writer's best friend is fear. And the very thing that sometimes immobilizes you, that sometimes is the thing that gives you the chill and gives you the moment of freezing in your tracks, because you have great fear about going forward with your writing, about sometimes going forward with your life. It often runs parallel that way. Writing is very intimate. It is very much, you know, the details of your life put on the page, and especially if you are writing fiction, even more so are you writing your emotional truth. And of course, emotional truth always has to do with fear. And it's interesting to me that new writers tend to, because of their inexperience and because of the obvious fear they have about where they are with their writing, often hold that fear away and at arm's length. And the experienced writer, the professional writer, not only do they embrace that fear, but they learn to use the fear on the page and to define it in terms of what they are writing, and then learn to use it for the building blocks of conflict. Because their fear then translates to fear of character, fear of fear that goes into the issue of what's at stake, which then goes into the issue of motivation, and it is all interconnected. So what I would say to you is that great quote from FDR, there's nothing to fear but fear itself. And beyond that, I would say to you that fear really is your best friend. And once you learn to define it, to use it as a construct for your writing in a very real way, though, that fear will give you the element of authenticity, will give you the element of organic conflict within a scene, and will give you that sense of a universal story by the specificity of the fear itself. And the more you define the fear and give it the personal elements of your own life and translate it to character, the more your reader, translate that to buyer, will engage in the work, and ultimately the more your viewer, the paying audience, not only will they identify with your story, but hopefully they'll pay for the privilege of the pain over and over and over again. And that's what we call successful writing. It's what we call beautiful writing. And at UCLA, we also call it a beautiful cruelty. So love your fear, embrace your fear. And so I'll say to you, please visit me at voorscript.com. I'd love to give you more details about the mechanics of writing, all that awful, dreary stuff that you absolutely need to get you, not just through the script, but especially through Act Two, which is hard for all of us. I thank you for checking in and seeing if there's a way that you can benefit from these video chats. And I tell you now to embrace your fear and to write forward.